time for the Family Feud, introducing the Wallin family. Larry, Linda, Dale, Debbie, and Luann, ready for action. And the McKenna family. Dorothy, John, Mary Lou, Kevin, and Carol. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud. Here's the star of Family Feud, Richard Goodson.
This is just for our friends in New Orleans. On Monday, sometime, I don't know when, but on Monday, on this station, they're going to put a telephone number up. Call it. And our interviewers are going to come in and interview the first 500 families that call. You go in, if you can play the game, we'll fly you here. They put you up in some dump somewhere near. Where do we put them up?
West Covina.
West Covina. You have to walk in. Wallins are the champs. Yay! You have $1,299. And this is a success story. This is what I was talking about. Our friends here from Minneapolis, St. Paul, and I believe you're from Boston, aren't you?
Yeah.
So I'm all in here. Okay, let's meet your family.
Okay, Richard. On my left, my beautiful sister-in-law, Linda.
Hi, Richard.
Next to her is my brother, Dale, which is Linda's husband.
Yeah, you keep pointing that out. Okay.
My single and very beautiful sister, Debbie.
Debbie. Yeah.
Hi.
And on the end, my sister, Luann, the new mama.
New mama. Going to be challenged now from Boston, the McKenna. How you doing?
Oh, just fine, Richard, just fine.
When did they bring you in?
We came in yesterday.
Oh, yeah? Uh-huh. Are you all rested up? No jet lag or anything?
I'm fine now.
You're fine. Let's meet your family now.
Richard, this is my son, John.
Nice. How you doing, Richard? You.
And my daughter, Mary Lou.
Hi, hello. Richard.
Her husband, Kevin.
Hi, Richard.
And my youngest daughter, Carol.
Hi, Richard. Hi.
Let's see how Boston does versus the Twin Cities. We're going to play the feud. People surveyed, top seven answers are on the board. You got to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something you do when the TV's broken.
Read.
Read. Number one answer. The player pass.
We are going to play.
They're going to play.
Okay, Richard.
When he says that, he can do anything you like. Something you do when the TV's broken.
Well, this is an answer that shows up a lot. I've seen it. When in doubt, always say, make love.
Good answer.
Good answer.
Gene, make a note to break my television set. I knew there was a reason for the drought. make love! What do you think?
I would say probably after going to bed and making love, maybe sleeping.
Okay.
Good, that's all right.
Sleep! Not that. First strike, three of those, they get a chance to steal now. Just steal a kid.
Thank you.
Something you do when the TV's broken.
How about clean? Might clean your house?
Okay. Little house cleaning?
Good answer. Good answer.
Not that. Hey, Mama.
Hi.
Well?
Well, I don't think I could stand it around the house with no noise, so I would turn on the radio.
You know how to turn the radio on? Blow in its ear. Radio, say you're okay. If not, third strike. Radio! You got it! Well done.
Okay. TV's broke, right?
Looks that way to me. Yep. Yeah, that's
and
it
she's already got the radio on. Yeah. I guess I...
They've already made love.
Yeah.
He fell asleep. That brought a strike on. A little house cleaning, another strike.
How about if we go out, then?
Okay, but I don't kiss on the first date.
Oh, I see. No,
sorry. So lonely.
Go!
How about play cards?
Let's say you're okay. If not third strike, McKenna's got a chance to steal. Play cards!
Okay!
Very good, Donald. $7. Your answer's left.
How about talking on the telephone to friends?
Okay.
Good one, yes.
Friends, he qualified there. Talk on the phone. Not that. $67 for you. Come along, my little Bostonian.
All right.
Okay. What do you want?
Talk on the phone.
What do you say?
We're going to go to the movies.
Go to the movies? Is that the same as going out?
Sure. Oh, okay. All right.
Talk or visit friends.
Visiting friends. There you got $67. If not, Larry, we'll give it to you. Is it friends? Miss Ray. I do that watching television. Number five. Of course you wouldn't know anything about visiting friends. You don't have any friends. We'll be back right after.
It's a great way to spend the day.
Isn't that a great deal?
It's great.
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 Greater.
Greatest.
Very nice indeed.
Daytime Buzz. It's great. Weekdays starting at 10, only on BUZZR.
You're an English major? I was a lieutenant. $67 there, nothing there. Come, young man. Good luck. 100 people surveyed, top five answers on the board. Here is the question. Name something a father builds for his kids.
A tree fort.
Well, tree fort, obviously.
Tree house.
Means, yeah. Tree house or fort? Got it? We'll play it back. Talk it over.
I think we'll play this one.
Okay, oh, I know, because I did build that for my sons, and I know it's called a fort or a house.
Hi, Richard.
Nice to see. Something a father builds for his kids.
How about a go-kart?
Uh-huh. May we see if any of our 100 people say go-kart? Did not. First strike. Kevin?
Richard, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, sir. What do you think?
I would say a bicycle.
Bicycle? All righty. A bike! Hell of a thing to do. Hello.
Hello.
Bionic man strikes again. Something a father builds for his kids.
Maybe a doghouse?
Doghouse. Yeah, all righty. Take a look and see if it's there. Doghouse, okay. If not, third strike. Wallin's got a chance to steal. Doghouse! Not there. Look at this. $63 waiting for you.
What do we got now? Sandbox.
Got a couple good ones, but I think we'll go with sandbox.
Yeah.
Right. If it's there, you get the $63. Big lead. If not, a very even game, because Dorothy gets the money. Sandbox. Where's the other one?
You're thinking of models.
Models. Cars. Yeah. That's a good soapbox thing and little models. But let's take a look and see. Number two.
A swing.
Yeah, my dad built me a gallows. That's a long story. Number three.
Models.
Cheryl Teague's, things like that. Makes childhood so pleasant. Number four.
Dollhouse.
Oh, you're close with dog, yeah. And number five.
Oh, yes.
I remember Dolly Parton's dad building. Oh, I worked for years on that. We want to be back right after this. Just met Paul and Patty Beck, who've been married 3 days. And obviously all of the excitement is out of their marriage because they're sat watching a game show. Anyway, congratulations. $67 there, $63 there. Let's go. Dollar values are double. The first family to get 300 points will play for $5,000. 100 people surveyed. Top six answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something Scotch.
Yeah. Tape.
Tape. Three answers will beat it.
How about liquor? Liquor.
Liquor.
Play or pass.
Play, Richard.
Okay.
I love her. She concentrates.
How about leprechauns?
Leprechauns.
Okay. Well, you know.
Right, okay.
Scottish. Well.
Very famous. The Scottish leprechauns.
No, that was bad. I don't know. Okay.
They don't grant wishes. Steal money.
I'm sorry.
Don't be sorry. Imagine a leprechaun's fit. Leprechaun? No. Oh.
Well,
something Scotch.
Way back behind our Swedish ancestry, we have a little Scotch.
Uh-huh.
So I'd go with a Scottish plaid.
Very nice, yeah.
Good. Good answer. Good answer.
In the film, now here's my plaid.
How about the bagpipes?
Oh, great. Yeah. We're looking for bagpipes.
How about those, you know, the kilts?
Kilts,
or whatever.
Exactly what they are.
Kilts.
Oh, you're not supposed to wear anything underneath, by the way. That's truly, that's the
Nothing.
Tradition. Nothing. Ooh. Well, a little Chanel number 5. Kilts!
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. One more, you got it all. Something Scott.
Hey, how about that little hat they wear? I think it's called a beret.
That's a French Scotch person. Al Barreo or Camus Chanter, I believe. Beret! Not bad. Second strike.
Oh. Oh,
I love it.
Oh, yo.
You speaking Swedish, dear?
No. Oh.
3 seconds on something Scotch.
Gone.
Chance for you to get $174 here. Come along.
Let's go, gang.
Let's go.
Butterscotch.
Richard will go with butterscotch.
Butterscotch is there. You get the 174. If not, Larry and his family get it. Butterscotch! Got it. Number 6. Terrier. You had that. You had to decide one of the two there. 241 there. 63. Let's go. Doubled, 100 people surveyed. Top 4 answers on the board. Here is the question. Name a subject that a psychiatrist asks every patient.
Yeah. About their childhood?
Childhood! One answer will beat it. Name a subject that a psychiatrist asks every patient about.
Their occupation.
What's your job? Not there. You're going to play or pass?
Let's play. Let's play.
We're going to play.
About time, I might have. Subject that a psychiatrist asks every patient about.
I think they ask them how they're feeling.
Okay.
That's good. That's all right.
How are you? First shot, all right?
Richard, how about their sex life?
That's right.
Oh, yeah.
Sex! What do you think a psychiatrist asks every patient about?
Oh,
3 seconds, huh?
How about their work?
We had a job, all right.
Oh, we did.
We also had, how are you?
All right, their relationship with their friends.
Okay.
That's all right, that's okay.
All right, all right. All right.
How's your relationship with your friends? I can't complain. Yeah?
How about their dreams?
Dream!
They are okay, if not, there's right. Dreams!
How about, like, traumatic experiences they've had? I mean, I don't know.
Okay, good.
Wait a minute, what was that? Not being the past?
Oh, yeah.
Come on, darling, 3 seconds now. Subject the psychiatrist has every patient about.
Their family?
Good.
Yeah,
good.
Their
family?
Good answer.
All right.
Good answer.
What's your family like?
That's a good
great.
Answer.
Great. Fantastic.
Okay.
Good answer.
Family say you're okay. If not, third strike, they get a chance to steal. Family? No one is more surprised than this young lady. Well, there's only $63 there, Dorothy.
Only $63.
We have nice prizes for you, though.
That's
and we
very
hope
nice.
You had a nice time.
Oh, we had a marvelous time.
Enjoyed
thank
meeting.
You so much. Thank you, Richard, very much.
Thank you. Bye, my darling. Bye, love. Thank you. Who's going to play? Linda and Dale are going to try for the look right after we watch this.
Grab a hot cup of Joe, Bud, John, and Gary. BUZZR's Black and White Coffee Break, weekdays 2 Eastern, 11 Pacific.
Okay, we're going to do a little better, aren't we?
I hope so.
Well, of course, all our friends in New Orleans are watching.
Thank
give
you.
Give me 15 seconds, please. I said 15. Oh, I'm sorry. Huh? Ears like a hawk. I thought they were trying to slip 14 in there for a second. Name the age women start losing interest in sex.
35.
A city with lots of professional teams.
Philadelphia.
The biggest expense at a wedding reception.
The food.
Hardest emotion to hide.
Sadness.
All right, now I've got to give her one because she made me jump with her. A red flower.
A rose.
Turn around.
Oh, thank you. Oh.
When she said 35, I almost dropped the card.
I'm 32.
You're 32? Oh, she's got 3 years to go, this girl. Boy, oh boy, the age women start losing interest in sex. Said 30, 35, didn't you? Right. Survey said. Right, okay. Well, that's the bad news. The good news, they pick up again at 37. City with lots of professional teams, you said. Philly, survey said. Zero. Biggest expense of the wedding reception, you said. Food, survey said.
Okay.
Hardest emotion to hide, you said. Sadness survey said. 28. A red flower, you said. Rose survey said. Dale, come, my flower. Going to ask the same question. Can't duplicate. If you do, you hear that noise. I'll say try again. Wish you a lot of luck, okay?
Thank you.
Good. Okay. Please remind everyone the answers Linda gave us. 20 seconds on the clock. Name the age women start losing interest in sex.
30.
City with lots of professional teams.
New York.
The biggest expense at a wedding reception.
The booze.
The hardest emotion to hide.
Anger.
A red flower.
Carnation.
Turn around. Well, I got good news and I got bad news. The good news, you've been living on borrowed time for 2 years. I just told her she was 32. What sort of an answer is that, they give? How old are you?
32.
Yeah, well, anyway, we said, what was the age? You said 30, didn't you?
Yeah.
Lord alive. Service in? Zero. Yeah, this will come as a shock to both of you. 60. 60, yeah.
30 years.
We wanted a city with lots of professional teams. You said New York, survey said. 34. L.A., number one answer, L.A. You're now 43 points away from the money. Biggest expense, wedding reception. Booze, you said. Survey said. 41. Booze was the number one answer. Hardest emotion to hide. Obviously, with you two, it's not lust. You said anger. If it's worth 2 points, you got the money. Survey said.
Next, it's always fun when families play together until someone gives a stupid answer. That's when families pray together. More Family Feud mini marathon coming up.
For a group that loses interest at 30, something's going on, folks. We'll see you here in New Orleans. Don't forget to watch Monday. All of you watch. We love you here. Bye-bye.
Some departing contestants receive a True Test waffle maker from True Value Hardware Stores, who combine value and personal service in over 5,000 locations nationwide. And an assortment of exciting Maybelline eye, face, and nail cosmetics featuring new nail color. Protects and colors nails instantly furnished by Maybelline. And Foster Grant Design sunglasses to make the world look a little different to you. And vice versa. And from the Jovan Fragrance Collection for Men, Musk Oil Sex Appeal, Monsieur Jovan Sports Center, and Man by Jovan. This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.